For this next training video, we will perform the wrap feature. So in the wrap feature, we will create a sketch that will cover the surface of the cylindrical surface, which is called the cylindrical cone for this example. So first is how to perform that. We have to make a circle 1.5 inches and extrude it to 3 inches. So let's go to SolidWorks. So create file new, so make sure you are in IPS, so the inch per second unit. So put front plane extrude and smart dimension to 1.5, extrude to 3, then you have your extrude. So let's go to the here. So once you have done, you have to create a sketch na either in the top plane or the right plane, it's up for you. So we have to model it. So it uses a pi, since this is a circle, so we have to make it exact, so that it will meet, this point will meet when you wrap it, that will cover the whole surface area of the cylindrical cone. So that's why we will be using the formula 1.5 times pi. So since we want to sketch and wrap completely around the cylinder, so let's have to create this and sketch. So as stated, if you have seen the whole rectangle, so that's where the plane is projected. So we have to sketch center line, then have to model as stated here. So you have line here, then mirror, whereabouts, then let's dimension, put the dimension 0.75 first. Oops, sorry. 1.75, then 0.75, then 2 inches from the center. Then how long is this one? Where we will put the formula 1.5. times, you have to type it, so if there's any block here, nothing error. So it's already fully defined, as you can see. Then you have to make a fillet on all corners, 2.5 fillet. Yes, there you go. So you have the sketch. So once you are done, you have to make an offset. So as stated here, we will make an offset and select a chain and bidirectional 1, 2. That what means is bi-directional. Then the original sketch will be base construction, which is will be made out of center line, will be converted to center line. Then you'll have to close it to cap ends, either in arc or in line. Okay, so we have to perform that. So we have to specify the thickness of the offset, so 0.25. So I will select this one, bidirectional. So if you don't select bidirectional, only one side, cap ends, So a stated line, if arc you can see this. Then construction geometry, kasi we would not be able to make a wrap if we will not convert that original line to center line. So we have already converted it, and that's it. Exit the sketch. Then let's go to the wrap feature. So first select the sketch of the wrap, then select the boss and put a depth of 0.1. So reselect this one, then wrap. You can see the sketch is already selected, but what if I don't pre-select this one? I go directly to the wrap. I could also do that. Then select the face where we'll wrap it, and how deep is 0.1 stated there. So the boss is something you will remove a material. Emboss is you will add the material, and this one scribe is just putting a laser mark engraved. Okay, so for the demo, we select the boss, emboss, this one will be made out. Then if the boss, this one, and if scribe, this one. But if you want to change, reverse the direction, you have to, so you're adding the material in different way. This one, actually this is the model that we are trying to make. So that's is the, you use the reverse direction, this one. So I'm just curious what is analytical, and the wrap, what will be, oh, so notice that if we do analytical and wrap, there will be a different cutout, spline surface and a analytical. So let's go to analytical, this is default. Then once we are finished with that, we will be able to create a fillet and save it as cylindrical cam. So create a fillet 0.2, select the edges, then it will project across all. Then you have your, sorry if I have a big fillet, I'm not reading it properly, but good to know that it's editable. So you have to make sure that it is fillet type, tangent propagation, propagate. Okay, so have to check this one to make sure that it's propagating across all surfaces, edges. Okay, then once you have that, so control 7, control 5, project. Then you have your cylindrical cam. Save your file, cylindrical cam. And that's it.